We've got it. By Genesee Beer, the great outdoors in a glass. And by DiNardo Ford, your Southwest County Ford dealer. Once again, we're in the Carrier Dome at Syracuse as McCall Cablevision and Cable 13 Sports brings you NCAA lacrosse. The Carrier Dome, arguably the fastest and the finest lacrosse surface in all of the lacrosse world. Hello again, everybody. Dave Cohen along with Dale Dreifholzer here on the Dome. And I mentioned the surface, Dale, because Delaware is the team that plays on the natural grass. What will be the effect of going from grass to turf for them?
It won't be as much of a disadvantage as people might think. However, since Syracuse is so used to it and it is so fast and they have more team speed than Delaware, I think right away they're going to be in a little bit of trouble in that respect. Team speed is definitely a Syracuse asset, and the Delaware coaching staff knows it and mentioned it before the game.
But normally the team that does make the transition to the artificial surface picks up a little bit of foot speed. And for Delaware, they have a couple of players who are familiar with Syracuse fans and players. And here is Randy Powers, All-America tackler.
Yeah, he's the leading scorer in Delaware history, number three is. He's familiar, as you said, to local fans. There's Steve Shaw. Thing about him is he gets 77% of his faceoffs. Watch him. Syracuse is going to have to deal with the faceoff situation, one of the things they had trouble with last year, and they are working very hard on this year.
Last time we saw Syracuse playing here on the Cable 13, the faceoffs were kind of not really a factor. The ball was almost dead on the middle yard stripe. But tonight, you know, faceoffs could become more of a factor. From Syracuse's standpoint, excellent firepower from Tom Corey and from the little man, Gordy Mapes. Corey, right from Syracuse out of West Genesee.
Both of those guys are accounting for a lot of points so far. Corey's got 28 points, and Gordy Mapes has 22. Good assists, lots of movement of the ball, and I think everybody is really satisfied so far with the Syracuse offense. People say a little more balanced, the ball moves around a lot, so Syracuse has had pretty good offensive luck so far this season.
Delaware's been playing lacrosse since 1949, yet they do not have a single high school player from the state of Delaware. Back with the opening lineups right after this. So you want to play the game? Then you've got to go to the Varsity Sports Shop, the largest supplier of lacrosse equipment in Central New York, including Brian's famous shotgun and Super Light, or STX Excalibur or Laser Light, plus helmets, gloves, and pads. Everything you need to play the game, any game. Varsity stocks a complete line of sporting goods and supplies, fine athletic footwear, and school jackets. Mention this Cable 13 ad and take 10% off anything in the store. Varsity Sports Shop, Burnett Avenue, just west of Midler.
Out Syracuse. Hey, if it says Syracuse, we got it. Jerseys, jackets, sweaters, sweatshirts, custom tees, and more at Tops to Please.
If you want to look cool and you got to have a town, you're in Syracuse and you want to go home.
MasterCard and Visa welcome. 173 and a half Marshall Street.
And here's the starting lineup for the Delaware attack. The Blue Hens will have Randy Powers, John Lux, and Dave Metzbauer. Lux with two goals, Powers with four. The midfield, Steve Shore has four goals. Butch Marino has five, and Paul Canizzo, also from the Syracuse area. And starting on defense, Dan Harley, Bill Kemp, and Joe Jr., all seniors. They'll be playing in front of this freshman, Gerard DeLira. There it is, the Delaware Blue Hens starting lineup. And for Syracuse on the attack, Tom Corey, Tom Nelson, and John Zulberti. Zulberti, the freshman in the middle. The Syracuse midfield will have Todd Curry, Eric Jeschke, and Rhett Cavanaugh. And on the Syracuse defense, they'll have Sheehan, Pratt, and Desco, the brother of the Syracuse assistant coach. That's Jeff Desco, his brother. John is the assistant coach. They'll be playing in front of Jim Guyrie, the Syracuse goalie, stopping nearly 65% of all shots. There's the starting lineups. Back with the opening faceoff right after this. They've been to the national championship game 3 years in a row. Will 1986 be the year that Syracuse regains the title? Stay with Cable 13 all season long for coverage of each and every Syracuse home game and key away contests at Cornell and Hobart. Curry, Corey, Cavanaugh, and Cable 13. La creme de la crosse.
Since 1870, Syracuse University has offered those seeking a higher education the opportunity to share in its rich tradition of academic excellence and diversity. Over 300 different programs are offered by the university's 17 schools and colleges. Many of the programs, including those of the Newhouse School of Public Communication and the Maxwell School of Citizenship, enjoy international reputations. Syracuse University, an education for a lifetime.
And welcome back to the Carrier Dome at Syracuse. Before we left you, we mentioned that Delaware does not have any players from the state of Delaware on their roster. They are well represented, however, by New York and, of course, by Maryland. And once again tonight, we want to welcome everybody watching in Maryland, Virginia, North Carolina, parts of Pennsylvania, West Virginia, and the Washington, D.C. area on Home Team Sports. And we hope you enjoy tonight's contest as you look in at the bench of the Delaware Blue Hens. Both teams will be located on the near side of the field, as are all of the fans. That's why you don't see anybody on the far side in the stands. The face-offs should become a factor tonight. Steve Shaw, one of the premier face-off men in the country, Delaware number 21. Falcon Izzo lined up on the midfield stripe as we're underway, and Durgle controls the face for Syracuse as it knocked high in the air. Brett Cavanaugh pulls it down with Canizzo in pursuit. Also over there, number 21 for Delaware, Steve Shaw. Delayed call coming up.
Already a slash. Syracuse will have an opportunity to they can keep the ball. They
threw it out of bounds.
I think he threw it to one of the ball boys, maybe mistook him for one of his own players. He had the same kind of uniform on, but Syracuse will be man up with just 17 seconds gone in this first period.
And it's Butch Marino who is heading toward the bench. Actually, in the penalty area is John Lux.
Delaware penalty, number 16.
In the goal is Delira for the Blue Hens. And Delira is only a freshman, and I don't think you'd like to have him facing this man up so early in this Syracuse game, an important game for the Delaware lacrosse team.
Especially important because Delaware has lost their first two games to New Hampshire and to Navy. Now Tom Nelson fires in close, pass intended, and broken up. And here comes Delaware out of their own end momentarily. In pursuit, number 33, that's Bill Kemp, having trouble, and Syracuse Corey picks up the ground ball. The feed.
Well, they've got a lot of time. They're going to want to settle it down now and run their extra man offense.
John Zulberti sending it over to Gordy Mapes.
Oh, Mapes, nice job.
And it's taken away from him. Taken away there by Dave Poupard at Syracuse regained. It's Nelson.
Syracuse has been fortunate the two times that they have gotten the ball back in this first extra man situation.
Mark Brannigan is number 20. Syracuse working it behind the cage. Corey is open to the near side. It's loose in front and gathered in by Delira. He shoveled it past his man. And Syracuse will get it back as it went away from Kemp.
Yeah, the pass was intended for Kemp. Delira actually did a nice job. Very calm and getting it out, just flipped it over, but Kemp not able to handle it. They're even now. The penalty has expired, but once again, Syracuse is going to have an opportunity to get some shots off, and Dave, some shots they will take because they do get a lot off during a game.
Todd Curry is walking it in now to Rhett Cavanaugh. Curry playing with a bandaged thigh. He had a hamstring pull. Wore long pants in the last Carrier Dome game. Curry sending back behind the cage. Zulberti out front. Here's a shot. And it whistles wide, but Syracuse will keep it.
Good backup for Syracuse. Two men back there, and they will be. Corey will bring it in, number 42.
There are two players in this game who will represent the U.S. team in the World Lacrosse Tournament in Toronto, one for each team, Randy Powers and Todd Curry. They were high school teammates. Here's Corey feeding in front. Nobody's there. And let's see whose ball they rule it. Still stays in Syracuse's possession.
Very wide at the goal. Syracuse does not look real sharp in taking shots on the cage.
Looked like it was a pass to me.
Yeah, it did.
Again, it goes to Curry. And this is Cavanaugh. You've got Curry, Cavanaugh. And Zulberti, he's a freshman. Here's Curry, saved by Delira. And again, the outlet pass is knocked down. But it's a violation against Syracuse.
Hit it with his hand.
So most of the action was done in the Delaware defensive half of the field, but they have been able to do a nice job on Syracuse and have come up with absolutely nothing so far. 12:45 left early in the first period.
There's Steve Shaw, number 21. Syracuse will make them work coming out of their own end of the field here.
Syracuse is going to put a little pressure on this clear. As we said, Delaire, one of the men, the goalie, walking up, is a freshman, and like to make him think a little bit as they go about defending this clear attempt of Delaware.
Syracuse attack is applying the pressure, and here comes Nelson taking a run at the goalie to force the tempo. Ball is mishandled. Defenseman loses it. Hartley and Syracuse looking for the ground ball, but it's regained down there by Hartley, and a whistle will stop it. It's going to be Syracuse ball in Delaware territory, just outside the box.
I might mention the officials tonight, Walt Munsey, Steve Miller, and Joe Lachotte will be handling the midfield offside calls.
Here's how they line up in front of the crease, number 11, Eric Jeske. Tom Nelson calls play number one, or at least attack number one. Jeske is in front of the crease. Corey back behind to Zulberti. Now here's Curry and Corey. And low ground ball shot. Delira has no trouble with it, but he can't get it out. It's intercepted by Curry. Very much under control. Here's Zulberti. Pressure coming from Kemp. Now to Curry. Curry moving on Pouchard. The shot is wide. Syracuse keeps it again.
Delira, the freshman out of Wanton, New York, in the cage, has done a good job so far.
Harley, number eight, has the defensive assignment to the near side. And it's knocked into the stick of Delira. Delaware, I don't believe, has been across midfield yet in possession of the ball.
Syracuse is contesting every clear, not giving up, and hustling on the ball. They just have not been on the mark, and Delaware is now going to attempt to clear again. They've been caught changing people. They're kind of outnumbered. Now they come in.
And they get it in the stick of Shaw. Shaw finally gets it across. He's heading toward the box. He's into it now from behind. Kavanaugh breaks it up, and Syracuse comes up.
Ball on the ground. Transition game now for Syracuse. You see some of that speed we talked about.
It's Curry in the middle. Kavanaugh gets the shot. It's wide. And it's going to be Syracuse ball again. A little bit disputed by Delaware coach Bob Schillinglaw, who thought his goalie was closest to it as it went out of bounds.
A good example of what Schillinglaw talked to us about before the game, Dave, the team speed. That ball was down out of Shaw's stick. Syracuse headed up, transition game, and headed down the other side of the field and got a good break. Again, their shots have not been right on target, but you can see the speed they have.
Syracuse moving in closer now as they set up. Kavanaugh to Curry, and they reverse it to a man cutting from behind the cage. He shoots and scores. John Zulberti. He had been set up behind the cage as the feeder, and then all of a sudden, he came around from the top of the screen and beat Delira to get Syracuse the 1-0 lead. We'll get another look at it.
He beats Poupard here. He'll come around. You see right there, Poupard out of position and had the stick out, but he lost the body position. And boy, when you lose the body position down in that close, you're going to be in a bit of trouble. And Syracuse comes up with their first goal in 10:27 left in this first quarter.
Off the faceoff, it is Delaware winning at this time with Steve Shaw, a 77% winner on faceoff. They'll change on the fly as they send off one of the defensemen, Tyska, and coming on the field now is Canizzo.
Sturgill, the man who was facing off for Syracuse, was also recruited by Delaware.
From behind the cage, the Blue Hens work. Metzbauer, the attack man, getting big stick defensive pressure, and Dan Pratt takes it away. And Syracuse trying to transition well. They overthrow Sturgill at midfield. It's back in the stick of Delaire, who's fair game out of the net. Down he goes. And the pass
good
is nearly intercepted by Nelson. Nobody in the cage momentarily now. Delaire is there. Kemp is on him. Sturgill seeing more time in the offensive picture for Syracuse. Zulberti hustles and keeps it in play. Corey dumped to the turf by Harley. Syracuse gets it back. Zulberti coming in.
Well, one thing you can say about the Syracuse attack, they've been playing defense also. They've gotten the ball back, but they have not been able to put anything on the scoreboard with just about 6 minutes gone in this first quarter.
Syracuse sending on a fresh number now.
Pat Donahue checks in, 26. And now we've just got an isolation out on top.
And a ground ball shot. Again, it's wide of the cage, but Syracuse will keep it.
Chris Rossi took the shot. Syracuse retains possession, and they checking in a new defense now, getting out their shorter sticks. And the bench official, Mitchell Ashot, now starts things up.
Gordy Mapes has it. Harley's on him. Mapes reversing, trying to get an angle for a shot. He's pushed into the crease. What will the call be?
That's going to be called in the crease. He might argue he was pushed, but Gordy Mapes not able to get rid of the ball and ends up in the crease.
Syracuse taking off for Rossi and Brannigan. Here it is again. Watch Harley applying the pressure.
Yeah, Harley actually gets beat. It's kind of a push, but no matter. The officials saw it the other way, and Delaware will now attempt to clear the ball, but by cheaping it, Syracuse picks it up, and Pratt gets it back upfield. Syracuse big sticks will change.
Syracuse now getting on their middies as they can. O'Donnell heads for the sideline. And Todd Curry comes on now. In the meantime, Rhett Cavanaugh has the ball. Curry has come on. Now Jeschke comes on as Bedwini leaves the field. Still on the stick of Cavanaugh. Cavanaugh getting by Sepulveda for the shot. Hit the pipe, and it comes out.
Still a shot. Whoever's closest, we'll see when it goes out of bounds. We'll have to give it to Syracuse. Good hustle by Corey as he was right at the line when the ball went out without being over the line. So credit number 42, lots of hustle as he gets set to bring the ball in, and Joe Jr. will be guarding him. Now he drops back.
And in case you're wondering, Joe Jr. is a senior. Curry gets it to Cavanaugh. Pressure from Pete Carbone. Here's Harley on Mapes. Down he goes again. That's two times in a row that Harley has shoved Mapes to the turf. Cavanaugh against Carbone. Now Corey. Threw it across the middle, intended for Jeschke, who was deflected by Kemp. Jeschke picks it up.
That far sideline is a little bit farther than it looks.
There's Gordy Mapes. Good spin move. Finds Cavanaugh. Delira got a stick on it. It's loose. Corey is there. Sends backwards. And it is finally taken down.
He was
by
in and out
Junior
of there.
And Delira. And we will have a violation.
Goalie had possession of the ball momentarily when his foot was out, and then he just rocked back in with his back foot, Dave, and you can't do that. That's in and out.
Well, we played nearly half of the first quarter. Syracuse leading Delaware by the score of 1-0. We'll be right back.
Nine of their student athletes competed in the Olympics. Five of their eight baseball teams have qualified for postseason play. They've had 98 All-Americans in men's and women's track and field. They had the NCAA soccer champion in 1981. They sent a women's basketball team to the NCAA tourney the past three seasons. The Big East is a lot more than just men's basketball.
Check us out!
Imagine living in a place where the sports action never stops, where amateurs and professionals meet and compete in a variety of events, where four superb seasons of fun guarantee that nobody loses, no matter what sport they like, and where winning is a tradition. Imagine living in a place like this. You do.
You've got a share in Syracuse.
Syracuse 1 and Delaware nothing. We have 7:23 to play in the first quarter. Rather surprising, Dale, that Delaware's managed to stay so close.
Well, Syracuse has not looked especially sharp. Their shot selection has not been all that spectacular. But you can imagine how much pressure they put on. If their shots were on it, it could be a lot different story. But Schillinglaw right there has got to be pleased. His defense has done a good job, and they've had a lot of pressure put on them early. And once again, Syracuse still has the ball.
Has Delaware had a shot on goal yet?
I don't think they have. No, they have not.
Delira with another good save. And it rolls out of bounds. It'll be Delaware ball.
They thought it was a shot. Rhett Kavanaugh thought it was a shot, but it was not.
Leading his case with Walt Munsey.
Tessu's taken 11 shots so far, and Delira has 9 saves. So he's had a whole quarter's worth of work in about 8 minutes. Right now, this is what Syracuse has been able to do, put pressure on, and Delaware having a little bit of a problem in clearing the ball cleanly.
The starting goalie at the beginning of the year for Delaware was Dellargy. Steve Dellargy, however, he went down with a torn ligament and is expected back.
Well, when you've got two freshman goalies, it's nice to give them some experience, but you don't like to do it quite this early in their freshman season against a quality team, but he's so far done a nice job.
Canizzo has it off the pass from Kemp. Now he tosses it over to Butch Marino. Now they'll work from behind the cage. Metzbauer with the ball now, intending for Canizzo, and he throws it away. At the midfield stripe, Kemp battling against Corey.
Ooh.
And Nelson, a little high sticking in there. There's Bedwini shoving his lumber around. Steve Shaw has it, trying to get away from Bedwini. And he does.
Syracuse generally sticks man-to-man. And we'll see those matchups as they develop.
Randy Powers, second team All-America a year ago, all-time leading scorer at Delaware. Looking for his shot, changing hands twice.
Now they look like they're going to jump Powers if they get a chance, double team him when they
can. Steve Shaw spins free, and the pass is intercepted. Redirected back into the goal to Diary. Up ahead he goes, and quickly Syracuse looks to bring it across, and they do. Carrying it across for Syracuse is Chris Burt.
Big stick got it across. Syracuse fast break and a shot.
It's Chris Bedwini scoring. So just like that, Syracuse steals the ball down at the defensive end of the field. And they come upfield in a hurry to go up 2-0 now on Delaware.
Well, that's what they do so well. When your patterned offense isn't working, what do you turn to? And they started this off a stolen pass and a fast break. Here comes the assist. And we'll see the Dweeney shot. And right there, it zipped by on the left-hand side. And Syracuse is going to take a quick timeout. Delaware may have taken the timeout, and they're going to sit and talk about it for a second.
Well, Bob Schillinglaw, as you look at Roy Simmons, obviously happy, I think, that his team is in it. And with the second goal coming now, unhappy about the way that they transitioned so quickly. Maybe also about the poor pass down at the other end when Delaware looked like they were penetrating for their first real offensive opportunity.
As you said, that's one thing we can look for from Syracuse is that transition game and able to get the ball up. Chris Burt, 33, started the whole thing. He won't get an assist, but he obviously was a key in that particular score for Syracuse. I think Coach Simmons also thought there might have been a little push on Bedwini at the end, but as he talked to the officials, trying to work them early here as Syracuse comes out with a 2-0 lead. And a nice crowd.
Dale, you were an official in the high school ranks. How much do coaches get on officials in this sport, and how effective can it be?
Well, in the high school level, they used to get on you a lot, but I think as the coaches became more experienced, it's changed a bit. I don't think it's quite like baseball or sometimes like football where you have to get on them to get a call. I think it's a little less spirited, but you'll get coaches. Richie Moran is famous, one of the college coaches. He'll let the officials know what's going on, and I think that's just part of the game. But it's actually all done in a pretty good vein.
Dergle wins the face. Syracuse into their offense now with Todd Curry. Dergle heads for the sideline, and Jeske will be coming on the field momentarily.
And they've just got an ISO out there with Curry.
And here's the shot to score. As you correctly called it, the ISO, and Todd Curry scores to make it a 3-0 Syracuse lead here with 5:03 to go in the first quarter.
Number 16, Todd
Curry just ISO'd. When they were changing, he saw that he had his man beat, took him left, came back right, and the shot was there, and Delira not able to stop that. Now, that's the kind of shot, granted, it's tough to stop, Dave, but that's the kind that when you make it, it really picks up your defense and your offense. Delira's had a good game so far, but that one got right by him.
That's goal number six on the year for Todd Curry. And once again, Syracuse controlled that last faceoff, got into their offense in a hurry, waited to get the right men on the field, the men they wanted. Dergel wins it again, this time from a new faceoff man. He took it away from Delaware's Tim Weinkauf.
No possession now. Syracuse has got possession. Nice job of scooping the ball up, and Desko got it back, and now they're up to the midfield line and over.
Dergel gets it to Corey. Corey waiting for his team to balance out, waiting for the proper men to get in position. Coming on is Jeske. He gives it to Jeske. The return to Corey mishandles, and Delaware takes it away. Kemp.
This is an unsettled situation that Delaware should take advantage of. They've not been able to clear the ball when they had to set it up, and now they're going to get it across. And a nice clear for Delaware, unless there's an offside.
Yes, it is offsides against the Blue Hens.
Well, that can explain sometimes why it's easy to get that ball across. But in essence, they really have been having trouble clearing the ball in a settled situation. But they had a fast break. It looked good. The call's going to hurt them. They're going to turn it over.
It's Syracuse 3 and Delaware nothing. Brannigan with the ball for Syracuse.
He's going to get double-teamed.
Splits the defense.
Yeah.
Still has it. Now Chris Rossi and Corey.
Zulberti behind the cage, and they're going to work that settled offense. They've got a 1-3-2 now, one man behind the cage, three guys spread out over the crease, and two guys on top right there playing catch.
John Zulberti is the man behind the crease. He's been there most of the time, but one time he came around the far side and got a pass and scored.
Well, if you can pass the ball well, you can really spread out the defense, and you get a chance when somebody pops out from the crease, like right there, number 26, Donahue popped out from the crease. As you whip that ball around, you get a chance to get it in there, and he gets a shot off as quickly as Donahue did. It's going to spell trouble for the defense. Watch the ball being worked around the outside. Brannigan, number 20, starts it. And then they get it over to Rossi. And now over to the wing. But watch Corey look for the man pop off. And there he is right there and takes a shot, not able to stop him. Number 15 in late, that's Bob Gallagher.
Donahue had a lot of time to catch the pass, get set, and really fire. And it was not quite point-blank range as Delaware wins the face. They're down 4-0. Steve Shaw to Powers. Powers passes in close, and it's by the intended man, who was number 13, Dave Metzbauer, who took a shove after the play was all over. Randy Powers not pulling the trigger, electing the pass, and Delaware still not able to get into their offense.
I think it was the right thing to do. It just was not an accurate pass, Dave. He did not have the shot. They were ready to kind of collapse on him, and the man was open, but it was a poor pass. So now Syracuse will clear. Jimmy Guyrie, the goalie who has not had a lot of work so far in this first quarter.
Has he had any?
Not much. He's had a chance to clear a couple times, but in terms of saves, he has not had a shot put on him. And he signals the fact that he wants to start to clear. Now people are going to start to move on the midfield.
He isn't just exercising, is he?
No, he's not.
He hasn't had to do much.
Well, they've got some set clears, and you want him to start it right there. There's Pratt over with the ball, the defenseman, and he doesn't want to hold on to it too long.
However, he's got ahead of steam, and he's looking for the return feed. He gets it, and the shot, a backhander, is wide and rolls out of bounds. Well, he might not have wanted to continue initially, but when he had the running room,
fans really liked it. Yeah, they really liked it. There it is. Watch the shot as he goes by. He's just going to backhand it with that big stick, and give credit to the goalie. He did a nice job, Delira, of staying on the shot.
Delira went right after the shot, so we knew it's tough to maneuver that big stick, and he went out there and created the contact.
You'd be surprised sometimes, however, if you get down there unmolested, what kind of spin and stuff that big stick will put on a ball. Syracuse once again working the ball around as they put their cutters on the crease and pass it behind to Zulberti.
Zulberti sends it outside. This is Brannigan, number 20, whipping it to Corey. Wanted to go one-on-one, I think. Back to Brannigan, nearly intercepted by Donahue in front of his own man. That's loose in front. Mates goes down.
He's going to be in the crease, I think, unless they call a push. Yeah, no possession, so Syracuse will retain possession as Mapes took a shove. There he is, number 3, Gordy Mapes. Out of Rochester, New York. One thing I noticed was Zulberti, Dave, he did a nice give and go there. He's been standing behind there and just passing and feeding and not doing a lot of cutting on that last play. He gave up a pass and beat his man by about 3 yards to the crease. They couldn't get the ball to him. We'll see if they might not work it again to Zulberti.
Now we'll see how Syracuse attacks.
Yeah, this is a nice shot. You get a pretty good idea of exactly what's going on. There's Zulberti behind the cage. He's got the ball right now, and you'll see those cutters going back and forth. Great shot, guys.
Deflected at the point. Delaware thought they might have a case to get it back. Harley running with a stick, trying to influence the official. Instead, it's Zulberti who runs it in. Kemp is going to come over and pressure him. Zulberti sends back.
And they work the ball around.
Now Curry in the middle. Intended for Jeschke, I believe. It was not handled cleanly. Still isn't handled by anybody. Delaware's got a lot of dark navy shirts around the ball. And finally they come away with it, or they did momentarily.
Carbone had it. Syracuse has got it.
And Pratt sends it back to the goalie, Guiry.
Well, you see how well Guiry just got that ball back up to Curry, now down to Corey.
There's that transition game. Corey looked for somebody to fill the middle. Nobody was there, and he throws it away intended for Zulberti.
Good pressure on him by Joe Jr. Forced that poor pass. But once again, you see the importance of the goalie in setting up the offense by getting that ball out quickly. And he hit Curry on a dead run who hit Corey. They tried the pass to Zulberti, went out of bounds, but a good job by the Syracuse offense. And once again, one of these set players for the Delaware team, something they've had trouble with in this game as we're down to about 1:10 left in the first quarter.
That's a good footwork to get it across.
That's an easy way to do it. If you can't pass it, run it over.
Behind the cage now, it's Marino.
That was 17 Sepulveda, by the way, who got the ball across for Delaware.
Metzbauer has it now. Sends it back out to Shaw. Randy Powers really has been quiet in this first quarter. He's in front of the cage now. Good move to get free by Metzbauer, but he doesn't get a shot away. Metzbauer, however, regains control. He feeds out front. It's mishandled. And Syracuse sticks it away. Chris Burt's going to come up with a ground ball. As the Syracuse player is spilled to the turf, gets up in stride. That was Bedwini. Syracuse moving well. Here's Gordy Mapes. Harley is giving him a little bit of a ride. He finds Tom Nelson.
O'Donnell's
going to get off the field as Mapes had the shot blocked right back into his stick. Against Harley. Take one. We tried to wrap it inside. It hit the pipe. And was somebody in? Yes.
That's the second time Mapes has been in. But you saw what happened when he didn't give the ball up. The Delaware defense just collapses on him. He ends up with three guys lying on top of him here. Watch. He's going to try to power from behind. And that's Harley on him right there. Eight over the head. Stick goes down. See them all collapse. Then the goalie comes out to add insult to injury and hits him in the head with the stick.
Gordy's tasted turf on three occasions tonight. And Harley's been around him each time.
Let's see if they look to run the ball across. They're going to, I was going to say, not much time. We'll try that last shot. Not much.
And so the end of the first quarter here in the Carrier Dome with Syracuse leading Delaware by the score of 4-0.
Everything in nature has its own trademark, and so does the taste of Genesee beer. The trademark of the rough grouse is the way he drums his wings. And the Genesee trademark is consistent premium quality because it's made in just one brewery. No wonder they call Genesee beer the great outdoors in a glass.
And try Genesee Light. You won't believe it's a light beer.
I'm a real beer drinker, and Genesee Light's a good tasting beer. Where did you hide the calories?
So you want to play the game? Then you've got to go to the Varsity Sports Shop, the largest supplier of lacrosse equipment in Central New York, including Brian's famous shotgun and Super Light, or STX Excalibur or Laser Light, plus helmets, gloves, and pads. Everything you need to play the game, any game. Varsity stocks a complete line of sporting goods and supplies, fine athletic footwear, and school jackets. Mention this Cable 13 ad and take 10% off anything in the store. Varsity Sports Shop, Vernon Avenue, just west of Midler. Second quarter about to begin. Here is the first quarter statistical story. Delaware blank in shots.
That's something that you really hate to see. Saves pretty impressive so far, but of course you don't want to see that happen in the first quarter. But the Delaware has to look good. Ground balls even, face-offs even, clears, not bad either, but it's that shot. Obviously, Syracuse has been getting the ball and keeping it down there and stopping Delaware's offense when it gets a chance and then just transitions the ball right back up again.
Delaware, amazingly, is only down 4-0.
As we said, Syracuse was not especially accurate. Those shots count as shots, but if you wanted to count good shots, they really didn't get that many good shots off. Corey's got two assists in the first quarter.
Here is Dergel to face off against Steve Shaw. Dergel got it out of there, but it's picked up by Shaw. Somebody took a run and a dive at him. Zulberti knocks him down. Kemp pursues it on the sideline.
This is the type of thing we talked about. The Syracuse offense just hustles, gets the ball back now on a pass, a faceoff that was actually dominated by Delaware, but the good hustle gets him the ball back, and once again, Valera and the defense are going to be tested.
Syracuse working at the goal to our left in this quarter, and we'll have the opportunity to watch them set up an offense sometime in the second quarter from our end zone camera. Right now, you're watching Rhett Kavanaugh, transferred from the U.S. Military Academy a couple of years ago. Delaware, good job. Not a particularly good shot.
That was the one I was looking for, where they popped Zulberti out after he got rid of the ball. But as you said, he just kind of played catch with the goalie.
Once again, it's Delaware trying to get that long pass to get out of their own end of the field that Syracuse intercepting. Curry, the feed to Zulberti, and the easy score. 5-0 as Todd Curry found John Zulberti.
This is Zulberti's second goal. And Syracuse's fifth. Once again, you said this set up by their inability to clear the ball. And boy, he just one-on-one fakes high and goes low. And you get a great shot there from the end zone camera of exactly what happens when Syracuse is able to pick up that easy ground ball and start a fast break again.
Is it a case of Delaware trying to transition themselves? That's accounting for those long passes?
It doesn't look like they really know exactly how they want to clear the ball, and it's not going to help them, obviously, as they go along, because a team like Syracuse is going to give them a lot of trouble with their speed. But he plays, Schillinglaw said, they play 7 of the top 15 teams, and they're coming right up in a row. So they're going to have to find that problem and get it solved quickly if they want to be successful this season.
5-0 Syracuse. Delaware looking for their first shot of the game.
John Lux in there for Delaware.
Randy Powers has the ball, played by Desco. Powers with a behind the back over the head pass or shot. What was it?
Walt Munsey, it becomes a moot point as the ball stays in bounds.
John Lux out of Jamesville DeWitt has it. Didn't he have a brother who played here?
A number of
at Syracuse
Lux brothers, yes. And one, I think, it played for Cortland.
That's right.
Right now, Syracuse out playing defense, number 33, Chris Burt. Way out now, ball behind to Powers.
Chris Spencer, number 37, on the field now for Delaware. Stick checked away by Desco, and the whistle stops it.
They call a hold on Powers, so Syracuse will have the opportunity now to clear the ball. There's Powers. He trots off the field. I'm sure there are a number of local people here who remember Mr. Powers.
Gyrie cranks the arm up. He's got Dan Pratt to the near side. And we have an offsides call.
All you got to do is step on the line. You have to have three men in the offensive half of the field and four in the other. But all you got to do is put your foot on the line, Dave, and you're offside. So if you're guarding somebody very closely and you're not watching your feet and your foot touches the line, you're as good as offside, whether you're 10 yards over, and that's what happened to Delaware.
Tim Nelson, the all-time leading point producer in Division I lacrosse, with a T-shirt. That's John Desco, the assistant coach, on the left, and the man in the middle, Roy Simmons, the third.
Nelson working on the master's degree, I believe, graduate assistant. This is his technical title.
Brother Tom is at the point, number 5. Here's the Syracuse high-powered attack. Tom Nelson. Brannigan, number 20. Now Todd Curry. Now behind the net, Zulberti. They send Curry out. He'll crank his shot up, and like a blur, it's by Delira.
For a couple of passes to the ball there, they had nobody behind. Then they quickly put Zulberti behind, and then he got the ball and popped it out to number 16. And we'll watch it right here as it gets whipped around. But look at all the room he's got. He's got 7 yards, and when you've got a rifle like Curry's got, you can't give him that much room and expect him not to put a real hard shot on the net.
And this shot appears to be a heavy shot, too. It doesn't have much hop to it. It just bores right in on you, and you can see Delira's late reaction. 6-0 Syracuse. Off the faceoff, Chris Rossi kicked it into his own stick. And now he dribbles it ahead to Durgle, who has it knocked away by Steve Shaw. Shaw shovels it ahead, intending for his man. Nelson is there to pick it up, and we'll have a stoppage of play.
It's going to be a push, and that will be Syracuse ball. The kind of mistake that Delaware does not want to make if they want to get back in this game. 6 goals is not really a lot if you've got the firepower to come back or you're going to play aggressively on defense and knock the ball down, but they have not shown so far. Delaware has not the ability to do that. They've had a lot of problems clearing the ball and getting it out and putting pressure on Syracuse offensively.
Mapes behind the cage. Zulberti, they go way out front now. Rossi, here's Gordy Mapes. Little flip pass ahead. I think that was a case of shooting before he had the ball in his stick.
Absolutely. Brannigan had everything all sighted up, didn't have the ball. See?
Oh, Mapes with a bullet, and Delira played it perfectly. Again, they try to catch Syracuse. This time they do. They move it across midfield quickly with Gallagher.
Take it.
There's a shot by Randy Powers.
Oh.
And a great save made by Guyrie. Powers again with it. In front, shot, score. It is a score for the Delaware Blue Hens, John Lux. As Guyrie was tested twice, the first two times of the game, he made the initial great save, and then he was beaten by John Lux.
This is the whole sequence of events of Powers. You see that rising ball, and, you know, actually, Guyrie was on that one pretty well, but there's the rebound. Here's the movement by Powers. And he gets it into Lux, who just came around from behind, and Lux was all by himself on the crease, and Guyrie did not have a chance.
Powers made a nice fake of that pass after he got the rebound. That might have frozen the Syracuse defense. And now off the face, Shaw gets it to Sepulveda, Dennis Sepulveda. He's got some pretty good legs. He moves it down quickly into the box. Played down there now by Tom Irvin, 31. 6-1 Syracuse lead. Here's Sepulveda.
That's what they've got to do. Delaware has got to transition and be able to come up with some quick goals.
They run a set play, it looks like, from right in front. Now Randy Powers will run the show. He gets it back to Sepulveda. Meanwhile, Syracuse calling out the defensive assignment. There's a shot. And no dark jerseys there, so Syracuse will get it back.
Syracuse doing a nice job of covering the cutters. So Sepulveda went one-on-one, took one shot. Syracuse covered it, and so that they're right back where they started from, taking one shot at the goal. In the transition game, you can get away with it. When you've got that set play, they got to do a little more hustling. But I think they've got to feel good about that last goal when 11:03 left. They're really right back in the game.
And we'll be telling you how you can win some tickets to the World Cup Lacrosse Tournament. Terry Owens picked up a pair. He's out of Camillus, New York. We'll tell you a little bit later how to enter and pick up a pair. Under 11 minutes to go in the first half. Syracuse in control, 6-1, maybe more.
Oh.
Pretty passing in front of the cage, and Tom Corey swats it in.
Real nice. Real nice pass on this. Here's the, from the end zone, there's the pass from Zulberti, and there's the shot. Just a beautiful classic way of getting the ball and moving it around so fast the goalie does not have time to get back and cover the pass. 7-1.
Really hard to fault Delira on that. His defense was nowhere in sight.
Oh, absolutely. That's actually what they did when they got their goal. We're going to see some movement. I think Durgle was moving. Yes, he was. A little bit before the whistle. As Shaw, one of the best faceoff men in the country, maybe he's got Durgle thinking a little bit, but he has done a good job so far. All the Syracuse faceoff men are holding their own, I would say.
Here we go now with Steve Shaw. moving up on Chris Burt, 33. Will he go left or right? He goes right, and he feeds in front. Score. Once again, it's John Lux who found the upper right-hand corner off the fine feed from Shaw, who went by Burt to the right side, and Lux is all alone. So it's a 7-2 game.
Lux was all alone because watch them jump. Here comes Shaw. Watch the defenseman jump right there. Now that leaves Lux all by himself. I think that was Sheehan that jumped, and there's just a perfect placement of the shot by Lux. So what happened was Syracuse jumped from the crease, and they left Lux alone, but the pass was right on the button, and that cost Syracuse their second goal, as with 10:32 left, the score is now 7-2.
And for those of you who may be watching for the first time, in that case, the jump was a double team of the man with the ball.
Now, Delaware, the face-off statistic becomes ever more important, as you can let them right back in the game if they can control the tempo, and that's exactly what they've done the last couple times down.
Which Marino, with the move, went by Cavanaugh, maybe hurt, and the ball that was nearly in the cage, Cavanaugh is definitely hurt. He's limping toward the sideline. Brett Cavanaugh has injured his left leg.
They've got the ball, meanwhile, to Sheehan, and they may be off. No, they're not offsides.
Syracuse thinks they are. Now they get Donahue on.
And they send Sheehan back as he was able to get the ball across, but in the Cavanaugh getting off the field, they were a little confused, just got onside, apparently. But now the Syracuse offense will be set up, and Curry out is going to get it off to Jeske.
And that man behind the net, as usual, Zulberti. Here's Syracuse setting up their offense. Donahue has it. He has replaced Brett Cavanaugh. Donahue starts it in, makes a good move. He fires over the cage to Zulberti, intercepted as they come back from behind the cage. Good defensive work there.
That's Teska, number 36.
And the ball stolen away by Curry. Tried to pass it blindly. And we get a little pushing and shoving now between Curry.
Yeah, that was Poupard.
And Canizzo.
And 38 right there is Poupard. That looked like a six for a while. There's Cavanaugh on the bench, and he, you know, Dave, he didn't even look like he got hit, and he just went down. May have been a cramp or...
I think there was contact when the pass was right around the shin level there. I think he got cracked right along that shin.
At any rate, they're going to take a look at that and see if they can't get him back in the game while the referees sort out the penalty situation. Unsportsmanlike, I think both sides, perhaps. We'll see.
It was Curry and Poupard.
Delaware's number 38, Dave Poupard, pushing 30 seconds. Syracuse number 16.
And they're sorting him out right now. Curry.
Unnecessary roughness, 1 minute.
So Delaware gets the best of that exchange. They got a 30, and Syracuse got a minute.
Well, and they'll have to stay at least 30 seconds, all right? And there's no possession, so there'll be a faceoff. Steve Miller makes the signal right there. When you have simultaneous fouls like that, and you've got two unequal penalty times, like that, the minimum amount of time served is the lesser penalty. So in that instance, it's 30 seconds for pushing. So they will have to serve at least 30 seconds. And there's the ice on Cavanaugh. It does not look, it's on the ankle, does not look like we will see him again as he's going to elevate that ankle.
Scoring of the game, Zulberti, Bedwini, Curry, and Donahue in the first quarter. Then Zulberti and Curry to make it 6-0. And then it was Lux with a pair of goals. Corey had one for Syracuse, so it is a 7-2 score. And Delaware has the man advantage.
They're actually both down a man,
that's
so
right,
they won't be until the 30-second penalty is served.
Now a little bit of confusion.
Oh, he's got a, his helmet is not snapped, and the official called timeout. If the rule is, of course, safety first, and if you can, if it's something that could endanger the player's safety, they're going to stop the game and get him set.
The confusion was in the penalty box area while the repairs were made.
Okay.
To Steve Shaw. So with 8:35 to go, Delaware is awaiting a man-up situation.
Yeah, they had the wrong man in the box. In other words, who was going to come in? They now have got 17 in the box. Sepulveda and He's still got some time left. He's in now, so man up situation for Delaware for 30 seconds.
Randy Powers has it. Being pursued by Desco, former high school teammate. There's a good move by Shaw to feed in close to Metzbar.
Oh, nice check by Pratt.
Tough angle for that shot, but somehow he gets it through there. Butch Marino scores. Bernard Butch Marino, another West Genesee product. I don't know how he threaded the needle on that, but he got it in, beating Gary. And this one now is a 7-3 game.
Pratt did a nice job of checking the ball out, but they got the ball out, and you'll see right there, Pratt was even in the cage, in the crease area, which you can have, but it was to no avail. As you said, Dave, he struck the ball right by.
He beat Burt Pratt and Gary 7-3. And you can sense a little bit of increased confidence on the Delaware sideline. They're slapping fives.
And once again, we'll see now this face-off situation as we look at the Delaware sideline.
A couple of smiles down there, 7-3. Here's the all-important face-off. Zirkle and Shaw again.
Shaw really has got a nice move. But see, he tried to get it out to his wingman, Kirby, and Kirby does not control it. It's now a ground ball situation.
And there's Shaw to pick it up. He's a real hoover out there, vacuuming up everything in sight last couple of minutes.
You'll find your face-off man is that type of a player.
Now they put it in the stick of Delira, and here comes Harley. Syracuse will mount some pressure again. And goes down as Delaware comes up. Lux behind the cage.
Lux has done some damage. It's now 13 with the ball. Metzbauer.
Randy Powers passes it by Chris Spencer.
Is intended for Spencer, not able to handle it. Incidentally, we've gotten word on Brett Kavanaugh. He has a sprained ankle. We'll probably not see any more action tonight. They've got the ice on. They've got it elevated. And there he is with that left ankle. Hopefully not a serious injury, but he definitely does not look like we'll see him anymore tonight.
Brett probably thought he had seen the last of those crew cuts when he was down at the military academy. Now it's suddenly in vogue again here at Syracuse.
They have tails on them here. I don't think they have those at the at any of the academies.
7 minutes to play, first half. Jeschke was calling for the ball, number 11, at the bottom of your screen. Meanwhile, some nifty footwork there by Curry, and now he spots Jeschke, who immediately passes it to Zulberti, comes in. He's in the crease.
He took a trip right through there, and that's going to cost Syracuse the ball. Didn't look like he had much of an angle, but he went through the crease. There's the pass from Jeschke. Watch Zulberti. Doesn't look like a real good angle. He's all by himself, but tried to reach that stick out, as you can see. He was only in there by about 4 or 5 steps. So Syracuse loses possession. There's John.
Wasn't Zulberti the man who began the tradition here? Carried over from high school?
I think so.
Freshman got to influence the upperclassmen. Now here comes Spencer across.
Now that's a nice clear. They've seem to have been working on that, talking about on the sidelines, and Spencer able to get the ball up very easily.
There's John Lux. He's got 2 of the 3 goals, and he beats his man, and he spins for the shot, and the rebound is up and in. Up off the turf, into the stick, and in the nets. It's put in by Jeff Kirby, 22, and it is now a 7-4 game.
That's a real fortunate goal now for Delaware, because I think they feel they're right in it. They're, watch, he gets ridden out. Sheehan rides him out. He kind of fans on the shot. Guyrie finds the ball, but too late, up over his shoulder. He might have come out on that. Guyrie, I think, is blaming himself for that last goal, and he maybe should. I don't know if he was if his vision was blocked out. Didn't look that way.
Canizzo was there and might have screened the vision of Guyrie. Canizzo just happened to be standing there.
Faceoffs are now taking on a decided blue tinge as Delaware has, I think, come up unofficially the last 3 in a row.
And Delaware has it now. Marino's got it. Marino is being played now by number 10 for Syracuse. That's Leland Rogers. And here's the shot to score again by Butch Marino. It is a 7-5 game.
As I said, if they could solve that clearing problem and they can dominate the faceoffs, which they have done here in the second quarter, that you're going to get Delaware right back in it. And it seems that they know exactly what they're supposed to do. They come around. Marino just takes a well-placed shot.
We've got ourselves a good one now.
Marino's struggling a little bit there in the goal, I think. David, maybe thinking a little bit too much after they got a couple of those early goals, but yeah, Syracuse has not been able to control the tempo.
Kyrie was on vacation in the first quarter, no shots. And suddenly Delaware close to a 2-1 advantage in the faceoffs.
And here it is. Boy, that ball really not out yet. And we're going to get a push.
Starting to get physical here between Syracuse and Delaware.
And that will cost Delaware the ball. They were detected pushing. But once again, one of the things we mentioned at the top is if, on top of the show, is if Syracuse could not control the faceoffs and the tempo of the game went to Delaware, they might be able to make a real game of it. And they've been able to do that and also seem to have cleared up their clearing problems.
And Dale, you said something very astute earlier in this quarter, a 6-goal deficit is not very hard to make up in Lacrosse. Right now we're at 7-5.
Oh.
Behind the back beauty by Tom Nelson.
And Gordy
off
Mapes
the feed from Gordy Mapes. Put that one in the highlight film for this year.
Goal by number
he was really relaxed. Looked like he, they've worked on that in practice. He was waiting for it. We'll get a nice shot out of it here from the end zone. There it is. Just look at that. Well, you got to believe, there's the goalie. Says, okay, he's got his stick covered to the right, so I'm just going to stay right in this position. And the ball comes from the opposite side as he puts it around his head. So Nelson picks up a sweet goal and gives Syracuse a little breathing room with 5:34 left as they make it 8-5 now.
Once again, Dergel and Shaw. Shaw wins it. Comes up with it. Great balance.
Oh, he gets a nice pass off.
Terrific athletic ability. Sepulveda trying to beat his man. Feeds in front. Intended there for Lux. Syracuse player has it. Now Guyrie gets it out. Syracuse looks to get it across in a hurry. They get it to Nelson. Into the middle. He
nice
goes.
Nice luck.
O'Donnell puts it into a smaller stick. And now coming in, Dergel. Saved by Delira. And Dergel went down hard. Now Delaware runs it up. And they get it across without much trouble. As I say that, the ball goes by the man. And out of bounds, Dave Poupard. We'll be back with more right after this.
It was a feeling started long ago, one bleak and wintry morn, when the call went out for volunteers in a nation being born. No sunshine, patriot speeches, no summer, soldier songs, for the special men who pay the price to keep the country strong. When we were needed, we were there.
Watching Cable 13, the lucky number for you. Play back in with 4:40 to go. Syracuse leading Delaware 8-5. And Syracuse with another errant pass over the head of Tom Corey. And Delaware gets it back. The Blue Hens were down at 1.6-0 with no shots. It is now a 7-5 game.
As we said, the game of lacrosse can change very quickly, and there are a couple of ways of doing it, and face-offs is the one that really seems to count, because if the other team scores, you get that opportunity if you can control the ball, and the coaching staff there at Delaware must be impressed so far with the comeback here. 4:34 left, and they have done a nice job of coming up on Syracuse in the second quarter.
Bob Schillinglaw, the coach of Delaware, as we said earlier on, has no players from the state of Delaware, but he played at North Carolina, and that's a state that has seldom turned out any players for that school. It's lost by Sepulveda, picked up, and here's a flag thrown.
And that's going to be against Syracuse. So that'll give a man up situation to the Delaware Blue Hens. I think O'Donnell, 31, trotting off the field, came up on the head with the stick. It's going to cost him a minute.
O'Donnell, 1 minute slashing. 31, O'Donnell slashing, 1 minute.
Syracuse generally doing pretty well in the extra man situation. In other words, when the other team, when they're man down, I should say. And they stop a majority of the shots.
Rob Webster has come on for the first time for Delaware. He is out of Sparks, Maryland. Syracuse 8, Delaware 5. Dave Cohen, Dale Dreipulcher. Delaware with the extra man opportunity. Spencer out to Powers. Ground ball, and Delaware will keep it.
Coming into the game, Dave, on 30 man up opportunities, the opposition only got 8 goals. So that's a real nice percentage.
And now it's Powers behind the cage. Metzbauer's 13, Spencer's 27. Gary saves. Marino's closest to it. Delaware will keep it.
A lot of action down there as they're getting some shots off in this extra man situation.
Randy Powers faking the pass.
Oh, he's great at that.
Shows you the ball, then he pulls it back. Delaware gets another shot.
You can tell his stick handling skills. There's Kavanaugh, and we'll see him leaving the field on the crutches with one of the SU trainers.
Obviously through for this game. Spencer, way out. I think that's Lux who went down.
Nice dodge by Lux. Ball is down. There's going to be a push against Delaware. And I don't know if the penalty's up. I'll tell you in a second. Yes, it is. So now they'll be even across, and Syracuse will have an opportunity to clear.
3:11 to go in the first half. It's 8-5 Syracuse.
I think some people thought it might be kind of a runaway there with that 6-0 lead that Syracuse had early, and they're back in the game are the Delaware Blue Hens and really putting the pressure on Syracuse.
Now Guyry is going to face some pressure. First time in the game, really, Delaware has elected to come out
and
try to force Syracuse into exactly what they just did, throwing it away.
Curry intended the pass for Jeske, but that was way over the head. And again, Dave, as you said, a perfect opportunity for Delaware, and that's exactly what they wanted to do.
We've got free tickets for those of you who will send us a postcard, courtesy of World Cup Lacrosse, Cable 13 Sports, McCaw Cablevision, 500 South Salina Street, Syracuse, New York, 13202. We'll pick out a lucky winner for each game. Terry Owens of Camillus, our winner tonight for a pair of tickets. And we'd love to get some responses from those of you watching throughout home team sports in the Mid-Atlantic states, the capital region, as you watch Gerard Delara come up the sideline nearly to midfield, and here comes Shaw. 2.5 minutes to go. Shaw spins free, shoots high in the air, taken away by a defenseman.
Bad pass. Syracuse defense now looks like Delaware's early in the errant passes and not being able to clear the ball when you have the opportunity.
Joe Jr. scooped it up at midfield. Now Randy Powers has it. Canizzo runs toward the middle. Shaw set a pick, but Powers really didn't use it. He's matched up with Desco. Now Lux, who has 2 goals.
There's a pass.
Here's the fake shot by Marino. Marino's got 2 goals already. Steve Shaw, he likes to go right. He's going right again. He splits the defense. And that hit the stick, I think, of the goalie, Guyry. And Guyry gets it upfield in a hurry. Good pass taken by Badwini. Badwini on the right wing to Corey. Behind the cage, Mapes. Mapes works one-on-one against Harley.
Harley really putting the aluminum on Mapes.
And he's been all over him all game long. Burt to Corey, who will come outside. Curry is coming on. He gets the pass.
Oh, nice fake. Burt wide open.
Burt looked like he was heading off the field, and he circled back toward the middle.
He took Marino downtown and left him there.
Now Marino's going to run right off the field with him.
And Jeske's going to come on.
Jeske comes on and immediately gets away from the defender coming on. Curry misses. Syracuse will keep it. Dave Poupard was trailing Jeske as he came on the field.
That's right. And that's a lot of strategy there. Timeout now for Delaware, I believe. and that's their second.
Delaware.
But a lot of strategy getting your subs in and out.
Bob Schillinglaw has done, has taken timeouts very judiciously in this game. Remember early on, he took one or two timeouts to prevent the game from getting away, even though it was only 1-0. Eventually, the score did go to 6-0, but Delaware has come back. He's done a fine job of coaching with a minute and 1 second to go in this first half.
I think you're absolutely right. It could have gotten out of hand, and as we said, he cleared up the problems they were having. That's kind of a pun, I guess. Cleared up the problems they had clearing the ball. The defense has made better passes. They've run it across when they needed to. And then that all-important faceoff, 21 doing such a good job. Steve Shaw, regarded as one of the best faceoff men in the country, has done his job. And, of course, after they've gotten the faceoff, Lux has done a nice job of putting the ball in the hole. So you've got to give Delaware, as you said, Dave, a lot of credit. They are back into it and did not panic. And I think they got to Guyrie with a couple of shots there. And we'll see how his psyche is that we're going to head into halftime in about a minute one.
Syracuse will be home again on Saturday, March the 29th against Adelphi, and then April the 5th against Brown. And the University of Delaware has their next test against Massachusetts.
Tough schedule played by Delaware, and Coach Schillinglaw said that it helps recruiting, and he seemed real proud of the program. They did not give athletic scholarships in the sport of lacrosse there. So they are a little bit of a disadvantage, he felt.
Delaware awards athletic scholarships in football, women's field hockey, and men's and women's basketball.
They double-teamed Corey, forced the ground ball. They've come up with it, and Delaware brings the ball across.
Gallagher listed as a defenseman. Good pass in front, but broken up, and somebody may have stepped in.
That's interference. He touched it wouldn't be interference because the goalie didn't have the ball, but his stick was in, hit the goalie. So must have had the foot on the crease, and that's going to give them.
Down now to 39 seconds to go. Excuse me, Dale.
I was just going to say it's going to give them 39 seconds. Syracuse, 39 seconds.
Here's where you don't want a defensive lapse either.
That's right. You don't want to have the ball passed into the stick of a defenseman and let him come up with an easy goal and put him right into scoring situation. Here's a break. Curry down the sideline. He's going to get run off.
Finds a man open into the box. They feed the far side. It was Mapes trying to sneak in the back door. 20 seconds to go now. Delaware should try to get it out of harm's way. They overthrow Carbone, and Syracuse will have another opportunity with 18 seconds left.
Plenty of time, actually. Now all they got to do is get that ball in there. The ball is well into Delaware territory there, and Syracuse is going to take a timeout and set something up, Dave.
Syracuse.
You see a couple of injured players along the sideline. That's Charlie Chatterton on the crutches. He's out with a broken foot. Also this year, a collarbone injury, is sideline Rich Katz, and Tony Grogan with a stress fracture of the leg. So injuries have taken their toll on Delaware, and in tonight's game, Brett Kavanaugh has gone down with an ankle injury for Syracuse. It's 8-5, 17 seconds left. Dale, so often in basketball, we see last-second play set up. What's a common play in the game of lacrosse?
Well, lots of times, what they'll try to do is put as many men as they can on the crease, screen the goalie, and then try to get a one-on-one shot, and then they'll crank it, and all of a sudden everybody in the crease will get out of the way, and the goalie won't see the ball to the last minute, and they hope to get that kind of a shot. We'll see if that's what they're going to do. They may just run a set play. 17 seconds is actually a whole lot of time with the speed Syracuse has got. They can get the ball down there quickly, and as I said, they're well into the side of the field where Delaware is going to be defending. So it should be interesting to see exactly what Coach Simmons does. Don't forget free tickets, World Cup Lacrosse. Let us know, 500 South Salina Street, if you're interested, and we'll be glad to put you in the World Cup Lacrosse in Toronto.
We'll pick out the lucky winners to send us a postcard. Here we go, 17 seconds. The clock is on the field.
They take the time now. They didn't panic. They got the ball out at the point. Oh.
8 seconds to go. Intercepted. Nicely done. And with 3 seconds, Delaware almost got a last-second shot. And the first half has expired. So an inspired first half by the Delaware Blue Hens, coming from a 6-0 deficit to narrow the halftime score to 8-5. We'll be back with more right after these words.
All right, fans, WrestleMania 2 comes to the world, and it's all happening Monday, April the 7th, 1986.
You know, April 17th is my birthday.
Well, I'm talking about April 7th. Happy birthday, by the way, in advance.
Well, thank you, but my birthday treat will be, you know, the great American hero. Let's think of some great American songs. Let me see now. Tea for Texas, tea for Tennessee, Lord, Lord, well, tea. There's no mention of a large black gentleman with a big thing down the middle of his head there, is there?
Mr. T, you're talking about.
Well, the song goes, and everybody in America loves the song. I don't know, nobody's ever whipped me in front of the entire world with a belt. I don't know, maybe he likes it, maybe he's used to it. I'm not sure. What do you talk about a guy that looks like that?
Well, what about these things, Roddy Piper? Just how you...
Boxing gloves, I know. You and Mr. T, the only time he wears them is to keep his little paws warm in Chicago.
Well, how much do you know about 16-ounce boxing gloves?
16 ounce? Nothing. 10 ounce? I'm deadly. Are you kidding me? You see, that's the difference, Mr. T. I do play Sun City. Doesn't matter to me. No, no, no. I like to fight you over there where all that turmoil is. Doesn't matter to me. I like to fight you with 10 ounce gloves on. That way, when you get through them big catcher's mitt eyes and them big catcher's mitt lips, you're all crushed and creamed around. Then I think to myself, I've got Joe Lewis in the corner. Smoking Joe Lewis.
Frazier.
Joe
Frazier.
That's right. That's another one down. It's Joe Frazier, isn't he? He's the guy that lost to L.E., right? Who's L.E.? He's the guy that I hip-tossed when I was 16 years old in the Olympic Auditorium when he was in his prime. Did he tell you that? I couldn't say that if it wasn't on national TV. I couldn't say nothing like that if it wasn't true, brother. There ain't none of these guys. Did I hurt you, baby? No more kids for you, huh?
The gloves above the waist.
Same
with Thank you very much. Pay-per-view, sign up now for WrestleMania 2.
Carrier Dome, where at halftime Syracuse leads Delaware 8-5. They're about to hear in the background the Liverpool High School marching band. Dave Cohen along with Dale Dreipulcher here in the Dome, our second cable cast of the year. And once again, we welcome you wherever you're watching in Syracuse and Central New York on McCall Cable Vision and new channels and on the Home Team Sports Network in the Middle Atlantic State. It was a game dominated early by Syracuse with a 6-0 lead, while Delaware did not manage a single shot on goal.
I think people were thinking blowout because, as you said, not only was the score a little bit out of hand, but they did not get a shot, as you said, and people were just, the crowd was saying, another rout like the Cortland game, but not so.
And Delaware, even though they were down 6-0 and not getting any shots, they were really not getting beaten very badly.
No, they weren't, and they were very patient. As a matter of fact, they had little problems, as we said earlier, with their defense, clearing the ball, giving Syracuse opportunities that perhaps they wouldn't have normally gotten. And then they settled down, and as I give them a lot of credit, they did not panic, and they got their offense going, started grabbing the faceoffs, and when they got the good shots, they took them and scored goals.
There's no doubt about the prettiest goal of the first half. It came off the stick of Tom Nelson of Syracuse, and here it is.
Yeah, Nelson is going to cut up onto the crease, and they're going to have him pretty well defended. And Delaware, the goalie, is going to slide right with him. And we'll see the pass. There's Nelson. Watch. The goalie slides, but he goes behind his head the other way. And that was one of the goals that helped get Syracuse a little bit of breathing room.
And here's the statistical story. Remember, at one time, it was about 13-0 shots after one quarter play. I think that's what it was. And Delaware coming back strongly in that second quarter. Delaware doing a good job in the nets. And Guyrie, who had nothing to contend with at all, gave up a couple in succession, and so Delaware is back in the game. And the faceoffs really are the telling tale.
Absolutely. Also clears the 10 for Delaware. I think they must have gotten 10 right in that second quarter because they have done a really nice job. Brought them back in the game, and I'm looking for a really exciting second half, and Syracuse better not relax because this Delaware team is going to come after them.
All right, that's the halftime story. We'll be back with the second half right after these words. Championship game 3 years in a row. Will 1986 be the year that Syracuse regains the title? Stay with Cable 13 all season long for coverage of each and every Syracuse home game and key away contest at Cornell and Hobart. Curry, Corey, Kavanaugh, and Cable 13. La creme de la crosse.
You know, the great outdoors and Genesee beer were made for each other. Now, isn't that an inviting glass of beer? Like a white-tailed deer bounding across a meadow, Genesee beer has a style all its own. Outdoor freshness, outstanding quality. No wonder they call Genesee beer the great outdoors in a glass.
And try Genesee Light. You won't believe it's a light beer.
I like it a lot, and I'm very shocked that it is a light beer. Yeah. It's the first light beer I've ever liked. A toast to Genesee.
Hi, I'm Brendan out of your Southwest County Ford dealer. Come on in and see our new showroom in Skinny Ellis, New York.
My makeup, my makeup.
Ba 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 boo.
Ah. Okay, guys, this way.
Wrong way, guys. Next go in, Melvin.
Hey, this place is a zoo.
Visit your zoo and see how the stars live.
In the Carrier Dome, we're getting set for the second half. Syracuse and the Blue Hens of Delaware. Roy Simmons comes on the field. That's Roy Simmons Jr., his dad, a lacrosse Hall of Famer, a legend, watching this game as he watches every game. Roy the third, an assistant coach. And here is the second goal of the game by Todd Curry.
Move the ball around, and we're just going to see a blistering shot from about 15 yards out. And as we said, if he gets an opportunity to take that, he's got the strength and power to really put that by the goalie.
Curry with two goals in the first half. The other scores by Zulberti, Bedwini, Donahue, Zulberti again, Corey, and Nelson. And the scoring for Delaware, a pair for Lux, a pair for Marino, and Kirby. It is an 8-5 score, with Syracuse in the lead. At one point, it was 6-0. Syracuse and Delaware. Delaware, by the way, will be the host this year for the Final Four of college lacrosse. It's the first time that format has been used. Delaware hosted the championship game a couple of years ago.
That's right. It's a nice grass field, and it's the kind of place that it's real fun to go down and have a good time. Weather down there is nice, and I think that you may see one of these teams there anyway. Syracuse not looking in that second quarter maybe as good as they should have, while Delaware did an exceptional job of playing, and they'd like to be in that playoff picture also.
We had a little bit of a longer halftime than usual with the marching band performing here on the dome, and so the team's now taking some warm-ups, about 10 seconds before they'll be blown to their benches, and we'll be ready for the second half face-off. And the face-offs, once again, all important, as Delaware has begun to dominate in that department.
The only thing that I think Syracuse might be able to feel good about is that this is going to be probably one of the best guys they're going to face all year in the face-off department. So, and they have not been blown out, but they have been face-offs of coming at just the right time, and they cashed in on the opportunities.
We mentioned to you earlier in the game that there are no fans seated on the far side of the field. However, there are fans in the luxury boxes on the far side of the field, and the boxes will come into your picture just above the top row of seats that you see there. All the fans seated on the near side, and there are some of the fortunate. And we remind you, Cortland and Syracuse. Well, they played already this year, and Syracuse won that game by a score of 21-5. Syracuse next in action against Adelphi, and then they'll have future contests against Brown, and we'll be on the road for games at Cornell and Hobart. That's coming up in the month of April. Right now, 15-minute third quarter about to begin. Syracuse leading at 8-5. Butch Marino is number 16 and Brannigan number 20 for Syracuse. In the faceoff area, it'll be Durgle and Shaw. And it was Shaw who provided the impetus for the ball as it came out. Brannigan has it now. Sending back way over everybody's head to Guirin. Quickly, Syracuse sticks it upfield. Aaron pass across midfield. Picked off by Carbone. The long stick of Pete Carbone. He brings it across. Weak pass in front. Knocked away by Metzbauer. Taken by Desko. And now Syracuse will wait. And they get it across. They put it in the stick of Durgle. Jeschke comes on. Brannigan's in the middle. Curry's in front of the cage. Corey works from behind the net.
They've got Corey behind now. 42. Jeschke's midfield out. Brannigan, Jeschke. And we're going to get an official time. As they adjust once again the helmet problem. Curry, who has had a problem with a hamstring muscle, looks like he may have done something to it again, and they've got that thigh taped up, the right thigh. And Syracuse, along with Kavanaugh now, they're losing some important people.
Curry's jogging on the sideline. I think he'll be coming back. Teams at equal strength. It's 8-5 Syracuse. No scoring yet in this third quarter. Zulberti in his familiar position now is the man behind the cage. Here comes Jeschke. Now Brannigan. And it's Corey to Zulberti. Kemp comes over. Kemp played a lot early. We hadn't seen much of him in the second quarter. Brannigan to Corey. Very deliberate Syracuse offense now. Zulberti overshoots a man in the vicinity of the cage. That was Neil Ault, I believe.
Desko did a nice job of getting the ball across, but it's down on the ground and picked up by Delaware.
And Delaware controlling it now. Poupard gets it to Lux. Lux sends it back to Carbone as both teams make changes. Carbone with a big stick. Overshoots his man. No, it's a good pass to Poupard. Poupard throwing it back across the midfield stripe. And some...
They're going to try to redirect, I think. They're in trouble if they... There they're going to get back to the goalie.
Schillinglaw, the coach, asking his team to slow it down.
Yeah, he didn't want him to make a mistake there. Delira had the ball. Now he's giving it off to defenseman Joe Jr., number 11, and they're going to wait, I think, until they get the right matchups on, get their offensive middies on, and get settled down. As we said, their clearing has improved from the beginning of the game, and we'll see if they do it. This is one of the ways they did it last time.
Sepulveda.
Yeah, he just kind of runs it up and then pops to the open man. So once again, a good clear for Delaware.
Sepulveda is quick. He got it to Shaw. Now Delaware on the attack with Lux against Pratt. Lux ducked away. Feeds in front. Shot saved. Guirin gathers it in. But Syracuse throws it away as they try to come upfield. Really an unforced error. 12-11 to go. Third quarter. Delaware gets it back.
They look like Delaware. As you see, the first quarter was not Delaware's best. They came back and five in the second. Syracuse, of course, even four apiece in each quarter. But I think Syracuse looks very similar to how Delaware looked in the first quarter.
Butch Marino sends for John Lux. Randy Powers was open to the near side. He cuts to the crease. Here's a cutter from a tough angle. Powers is closest to it. That was a real tough angle for a shot. He was moving left, shooting back right.
And Pratt and Sheen were in his face and really put the aluminum to him. And did not get the ball really on goal.
The markings for Lacrosse have been repainted on the field here at the Dome. The 30-yard line you see there is actually the beginning of the box. Canizzo, number 32, gets it down to Marino.
They won three men out of top, and they're just running cutters off.
Now here comes the hesitation move by Marino. Played loosely there by O'Donnell. Flag is down. It's going to be a delayed call against Syracuse. Randy Powers back out to Shaw. He cranks and scores. So Steve Shaw scores to make this an 8-6 Lacrosse game.
And there'll be a man up. I think they got O'Donnell on a slash. Watch the pass and then watch the shot. There's Powers. Nice fake. Gets it out to Shaw. He just goes Crank City from right out there, and that goes right by Guirin.
Randy Powers makes that fake so beautifully. He shows you the ball, and then he pulls it back.
You know, he makes it go so far out, you'd swear he couldn't get it back again and keep a hold of it, but he did, and he got it over to that man right there, Shaw, who has
doing a great job of single-handedly, not single-handedly, but certainly putting forth quite an effort, both from face-offs and in scoring that last goal. And Syracuse will be a man down.
The fact that Powers is short at 5'8 and does extend that stick out so far really makes it look like a shot or a pass.
Once again, the ball down. Syracuse not wanting to get beat in a fast break situation because they are down a man.
Here's Sepulveda. He's got those quick feet. He's got Shaw on the right. He cuts behind Shaw, feeds down low, and Delaware can move within one. Randy Powers goes back out to the point now. He's out of your picture. Now they're going to send it his way. Here he is, exchanging with Sepulveda. And they send it behind the cage to Metzbauer. Now Powers goes back to play it there. Shaw's open. Number 21, he'll get it.
They're going to slide over. They got to keep the slide.
Powers gets it back. His
nice
quick pass
job.
Intercepted by Pratt. And Pratt tries to leg it out. His pass into the midfield area, overthrown, and a marker is down.
I think that's a little late on somebody from Delaware.
Flag is thrown along the sideline. Dan Pratt threw his gloves off.
That's going to be unnecessary roughness, I think. Walt Munsey, official on the
Delaware
sideline, made the call, picks up his flag.
Unnecessary roughness, 1:21.
1 minute penalty Delaware assessed against Steve Shaw.
1 minute penalty.
Unnecessary roughness, as you called it, Dale. 10.5 to play, third quarter. This is a game.
Syracuse not man up yet. They're even, both men in the penalty box. Syracuse will have an extra man advantage in
Zulberti moving on Kemp, circling back.
Yeah, they're just going to go one-on-one. Now Syracuse is up a man as Corey steps on the field.
It's in the stick of Tom Nelson. He's waiting for somebody else to come on. Pratt that comes back on.
This is
Brannigan has it.
Important man up situation for Syracuse because give a lot of momentum and confidence to this Delaware team if Syracuse does not score.
Zulberti's pass intercepted
right away
by Poupard.
Poupard has played a really good game for Delaware, and once again he stole the ball. Syracuse squandering this man up opportunity. Going to be another penalty here.
Legal substitution may be the call. Somebody jumped on, jumped
yeah
off.
Illegal procedure.
Man in the penalty box, I believe that they did have an illegal substitution, and Mr. LaShot, the official, right on it.
So that cost Delaware possession, and a big possession, too. 9:45 to go. Syracuse leads by two.
Still man up.
Zulberti, a little bloop pass, hard shot, hit something and went high in the air and beyond the back line.
So Syracuse quite fortunate after, as I said, squandering that extra man opportunity, gets another chance here.
Zulberti right in front. Nobody played Tom Nelson.
Made it look easy, didn't they, on that particular play?
Sleeping on the inbounds play.
Yeah, it's, you know, it's similar to one of those basketball plays, Dave. If you don't watch your man every second, it could be disaster. And Nelson shook loose. There's Zulberti. He beats Poupard, and he just blows by one-on-one. But Poupard, 38, who we said has had a really good game, got fooled on that one.
He had his back to him.
Well, it's tough. That's why they call it extra man, and it's tough to watch everybody. You certainly can't play man-to-man, but you have to watch him on that quick inbounds throw in. And
so once again, Delaware is down by three. The closest they have been has been two goals. Syracuse trying to control the faceoff. Nelson does. Dishes it to Dergel, who comes out of the pack.
Well, you got to give it Syracuse a lot of credit getting the ground ball off the faceoff. They hustled because, actually, I would have to say that Shaw controlled it.
Gordy Mapes comes on. Dergel is heading off.
Yeah, once again, they got a fast break with an extra man in there because they ran the fake where they went out of bounds, but it was too far away for Zulberti to take advantage of.
Gordy Mapes with the ball, shakes free of one, feeds backwards, and a low shot is gathered in by the goalie, Delira.
Poupard having a bad series here. He's going to get a cross-check called on him, and that's going to cost him one.
That's a call that's being made with increased frequency this year, but it's the first time we've had it in this game.
Number 38, Dave Poupard, cross-checking 1 minute.
So Syracuse last goal man-up situation. See how they do with this man-up situation. 9-6 now, a little bit of breathing room, 8:53 in this third quarter.
Delaware not giving up by any means and really putting the pressure on Syracuse, but Syracuse benefiting from the extra man. You can hear them yelling cutters. You got to watch. Oh, boy.
They really collapsed on Nelson. Good job by Harley. Nelson's in hot pursuit. So is Brannigan.
Good hustle by Nelson and Brannigan saving that. And they get the ball out to Corey, who's going to send it out on top.
Oh, Delaro with a great save.
Oh, and Syracuse, yeah, Desco, great job.
Brannigan to Corey took his eye off the pass. And that will allow Delaware to get back in defensive position.
Both teams hustling, Dave, and working very, very hard. They feed the crease ball down again.
Here comes the battle at midfield.
Oh, that's offside.
Delaware stepped over, I think.
Yes, they were offside. You know, if you go over and you have the stick over and your hands are down, you wouldn't be offside, but you got to get up, and if you take a hand off the stick, you're offside.
Syracuse leads 9-6. Hard shot coming, but it was deflected, and it rolls out of bounds. The official, looking for help, calls it in Syracuse's favor.
Sometimes that pays dividends when you take that crank shot, and the crease defenseman there take a couple off the shins and off the head. They might move a little sooner the next time. But that ball definitely bounced high. Syracuse retains possession. Zulberti pass.
Kemp took a run at Zulberti, and Delaware's doing a good job, Dale, of deflecting those passes coming from behind the cage.
They're sacrificing the body, Dave. They're getting in front of those, and you got to give them a lot of credit. They've done a really nice job, and Syracuse, much like the beginning of the game, have put a lot of offensive pressure on them this whole third quarter, and a lot of the game has been played down in this end of Delaware's.
Eric Jeschke with the ball now, number 11. Syracuse lost Rhett Kavanaugh earlier with an ankle injury. Curry went out momentarily, but he's back in the game. Here's Corey sneaking free. Shot was high, if it was a shot.
Yeah, I think they'll call it a shot. They do. You know, it doesn't matter how hard it is. It's the referee's decision, and he called a shot. Syracuse will bring it in.
Scott Finico comes on.
All even, incidentally, we should mention.
A defenseman out of Seneca Falls, New York. Mercersburg Academy graduate. Corey to Zulberti. He usually goes to that side. He feeds out front. And Nelson's shot misses. Syracuse will keep it again. 6:49 to go. This has been a rapidly played third quarter.
Zulberti does a nice job. He carries the ball around from behind, and when he gets doubled, when he gets jumped, he dumps the ball off very well, and that's exactly what he's going to do it again. Watch it.
Once again, he goes to the right side, ducks under, reverses, bloops out front. Here's Brannigan faking. Brannigan feeding.
Oh,
Delaro with maybe the save of the game.
Head save.
He's played a whale of a game. Only a freshman. Gerard Delaro and the Nets from Long Island. They tried to get it to Corey, but once again, the defense not allowing that pass. Up in the air, Corey pulls it down.
28 shots and 20 saves for the goalie from Long Island in the Nets for Delaware.
Neil all in the game, number 8. Carbone is checking him. Finico is guarding Nelson, and Kemp comes over now to play on Zulberti. Corey is working behind the cage now. He's got it. He feeds in front. They shovel it over
garbage
the head of the goal and over Corey. Somebody could have stepped in the crease the way the official is looking.
Well, the ball was down in the crease, and they were all shoveling for it. May even have a penalty here. Unnecessary roughness on Zulberti. So Syracuse is now going to find themselves in a man-down position. I think that's the official call.
Well, you can see the intensity there on the faces of the fans. Delaro with a save of the game right here. Let's look at it again.
Brannigan gets jumped there, and he's going to make a long pass across. There's the guy with the stick. But a real nice job, boy. The body position, and Delaro just bounced that ball right out of there. You can see for a freshman or for a senior, he's had a real good game. But you don't expect that kind of a game out of a freshman, and he's done a super job tonight.
They list him as 170 pounds out of Wantagh High School on Long Island. 5'10" goalie. Syracuse has a 6'7" attack man, John Rademacher.
Syracuse, a little bit of an advantage here. They had to face off in this end. They may be able to, I was going to say, if they could come up with the ball, they might be able to do something and get this penalty over with, but they're not going to be able to.
Joe Jr. lost it initially, but Delaware gets it back. They throw it over Harley's head, and the Orange men will take control.
Syracuse, as I said, had a heck of an opportunity. There was no possession, so they had to face the ball off. It was on the ground. Syracuse could not come up with it within the box, the area, and that would have released their Zulberti, who's in the penalty box. But you watch if they don't double the ball, Dave. But he gets rid of it quickly. So Syracuse, not much pressure, and they're a man down.
They have the ball, though. It's Tom Corey moving in on Kemp. Works free. They dislodge the ball, but he sticks it out to Jeschke. Now Brannigan. He has a good change of direction move, looping it back. Jeschke somehow pulls it down. There's a marker going down on the play.
They got Jeschke on the head and the back. Yep. They're going to give him 30-second technical on a push. He got it in the back.
Gordy Mapes will come on as Jeschke checks out.
There's Jeschke. He's got the ball. Turns the back. There's the push right there. Definitely. Good call by Steve Miller, the official. So a 30 second. Poupard is, he's had his troubles here. He's looked good, but he's had a little penalty problem this third quarter. So team's even now.
Nelson fires. Mapes was back there to give Syracuse possession again. Under 5 minutes to go in this third quarter.
Both teams down a man, even, but down a man.
Nelson, down to Brannigan. Kept his eye on the ball, regained control. Here come the two men out of the penalty box. Zulberti beating Carbone into the field of action. He comes right in with a backhander and a great save by DeLira. And here comes Delaware trying to transition it. The defenseman gets it across. And John Lutton knocked away.
Good hustle.
Marker is down, however.
That's going to be against Pratt, I think.
Pratt committing the infraction against John Lux.
Got him on the head. I was going to say that was real good hustle. Syracuse had three men on the ball, not allowing Delaware the chance to come up with any kind of a fast break, but he got him on the head, and we'll see once again that save by DeLira. This is the watch 34 running in from the penalty area, and it's behind the head, and DeLira had it the whole way. He was not fooled for a second. So the freshman goalie once again does a nice job of keeping Delaware in this game. They're only down 9-6. 4:20 left to go in the third quarter.
Zulberti came out of the penalty box and made a beeline for the net. I think DeLira had him all the way. And he aggressively came out to play that behind the back shot. Real good third quarter of lacrosse. Now Delaware in control. Here's Marino. He fakes, he shoots.
Good
that was
coverage.
A tough shot, too, by Marino. Good fake. And Gary got a stick and maybe a foot on it.
He had it covered at any rate. If it had gone inside, I think he would have made the save. But
Brett Kavanaugh coming back on. He's got the left ankle problem. Spencer outside, shot, dug out nicely. Very predictable hops on the AstroTurf, and Gary went down to play it. Jim Gary, redshirted a year ago. He's out of Annapolis, Maryland. A stay-at-home goalie. Jesko getting pressure from Metzbauer.
He's got 4 seconds in there. He's going to take his time, too, because Syracuse is still down a man, and they can take all the time they want. Until
I'm sure Delaware would like to shorten this game down to a couple of minutes.
Oh, sure they would. And Syracuse now pops the ball up, give and go.
Brannigan losing the handle, getting it back. Poupard, step for step, stride for stride, applying pressure. Nelson gets checked by Kemp. Jeschke has it all alone.
Syracuse still with a man in the penalty box.
Now watch how Delaware sits back. They go into a real tight defense.
Now they're even.
Within 15 yards of their cage. Jeschke intercepted again by Harley. Does a good job to get away, and he made an elect to bring it right across himself.
Jeschke forced that pass a little, I think, and Harley was right there and read him. Now they're putting the pressure on this defense.
Joe Jr. got hooked And Tom Nelson picks it up. His pass is deflected by Junior, played by Dergel, or make it Zulberti. Zulberti trying to ward off the defender, Kemp.
Kemp took his glove off. Actually, you're right. Zulberti was warding it off, which is not really legal, but it was kind of a toss-up as to whether he got slashed or warded. So when the glove came off, they stopped the game, and no penalty called. Good job.
2:28 to go. Third quarter, still 9-6. We had an 8-5 game at halftime, so each team has scored once in the third quarter. I don't know if Brannigan has taken a shot yet.
He's working the ball, Ron. That's his job.
Here he comes with a shot. Knocked down out at the point. Carbone applying the defensive pressure.
Yeah, defensive pressure by putting his leg or his chest in front, and they're really stopping some shots. Yes, sir. It's a human sacrifice in there.
Now Corey beats his man, beats Junior, feeds way outside, and again, the stick of Harley is there to break it up, and Harley runs it down.
He's played very, very well defensively.
Nelson was there. Syracuse will keep it. He's gotten his stick on more passes and more shots.
He's had an excellent game. He's a senior out of Massapequa, New York, and has done a really nice job.
The end zone look at the Syracuse offense as Jeschke gets it out to Corey. Corey playing outside now at the point for the first time. And here's the reason why. I didn't even see that shot.
You know, that's he does have probably one of the hardest shots around, and you can imagine what it's like waiting for it in that 36 square foot goal area. And it's hard enough when you don't have people standing in front of him. When he can put that kind of speed on it.
Zulberti behind the cage now to Nelson. Again, Corey is way outside. Brannigan to the near side. Delaware's really packing in. One man's going out to play Corey. The rest of them now within 10 yards.
Yeah, they're not giving them very much on the crease area. Cortland, for a while, although the score didn't indicate it, really did a pretty nice job of keeping that crease area clean. What happened was in the Cortland game, as Syracuse started going one-on-one, beating them from behind the cage and on the wings, and when they drew a man, they'd dish it off or score. But they haven't been able to do that. Good defense by Delaware.
Zulberti gets by Kemp. Delayed call.
He got mugged. Hey, Kemp up on his head, and that'll cost him a hold.
He got hit more than once by Kemp, who knew the penalty was coming, so he got in a second lick.
Big time Lacrosse. They'll give you a hold on that.
Fouls on number 33, Bill Kemp of Delaware, holding 30 seconds. 33, Kemp, Delaware, 30 seconds, holding.
1 minute and 8 seconds to play. Syracuse leads 9-6. Zulberti.
Pass going to go all the way to the midfield line. Delaware had it for a second. Run down by Syracuse, and
Neil Ault gets it down to Corey. Behind the cage is Zulberti. He gets it now. Nelson's in front. Zulberti gets it to Nelson. Behind the back, and it's wide.
There's zero for one for four, I think, on behind the back shots. I don't know if you have to take that shot. It's nice, and it looks great if you can beat him, but
Zulberti sends it outside again to Gordy Mapes. We're under a minute to go. In fact, under 30 seconds to go in this quarter. Again, it's broken up as they try that pass from behind the cage. And here comes Delaware with the ball in possession of Bob Gallagher.
Gallagher hustling down that far sideline.
5 seconds to go. Randy Powers with 2 seconds. They won't get a shot away. So the end of the third quarter with a score, Syracuse 9 and Delaware 6. So you want to play the game. Then you've got to go to the Varsity Sports Shop, the largest supplier of lacrosse equipment in Central New York, including Brian's famous shotgun and Super Light, or STX Excalibur or Laser Light, plus helmets, gloves, and pads, everything you need to play the game, any game. Varsity stocks a complete line of sporting goods and supplies. Find athletic footwear and school jackets. Mention this Cable 13 ad and take 10% off anything in the store. Varsity Sports Shop, Burnett Avenue, just west of Midler.
The World Wrestling Federation brings you WrestleMania 2, April 7th, exclusively on this cable system. All of your favorite WWF stars will be in action. All the excitement, all the thrills, all the glitter, all better than ever in the greatest wrestling event of the year. Be a part of this entertainment spectacular. Join the millions who will view this event nationwide, April 7th. WrestleMania 2, what the world is coming to. Contact this cable system for complete details.
Just a couple of minutes ago, you saw Rhett Kavanaugh come back on the field dressed in civilian clothes. He suffered an injury back in the first half of the game. We have Rhett on headsets down on the sideline. Rhett, what's the nature of your injury?
On the last play I was in, I rolled my ankle, and the doctor said it was a third-degree sprain, and I'm not really sure like how serious that is, but I'm going in for x-rays tomorrow, and he was talking about 2 weeks.
Mm-hmm. Give us your analysis of how Delaware's been able to come back when they didn't have a shot at all in the first quarter.
I don't know. As you know, a lot of the first half I spent in the locker room, and I just heard the score at halftime. But I don't know. The intensity of our team just doesn't seem to be up, and they really don't have anything to lose playing us, and they're just coming out firing.
All right, Eric Jeske goes down. Delaware's doing a good job of deflecting passes coming from behind the cage.
Well, they're playing a zone on us, so it's their way of slowing down our attack. They know man for man. They know man for man that they can't stay with us, so their only real chance is to fall back into a tight zone and try and pick the passes off as they're going around and hope for outside shots their goalie might be able to save.
All right, Rhett, get off those crutches and get back into action quickly.
Okay.
Rhett Kavanaugh, as we watch action here in the fourth quarter, a 9-6 Syracuse lead. Syracuse has led all the way. Dave Cohen, Dale Dreipolscher with you on Cable 13 and Home Team Sports.
Andy Smith, number 12, just got the faceoff while we're talking to Rhett. There's a shot.
Flag away from the play.
It was down for a long time before that shot was taken.
As a Jeske, I don't know if that was a shot or a pass. It was played behind the cage.
Kemp, I think, is going to go out. And one of the things that Kavanaugh said is they're packing that in, as we indicated, and they're getting the sticks up on the ball because they're playing that zone, and occasionally you'll see them when they isolate, they'll have to go man-to-man, but they do a lot of checking and trying to check the passes that comes in from behind the cage, and they've been very, very effective at it in the second half.
Lacrosse has traditionally, Dale, been a game played and enjoyed by the young, but it's really nice to see a lot of the older folks in the community coming out to watch the game. Certainly television exposure has helped the sport, and it's the thing to do after basketball season. And in close, Delira with another fine save. Delira has the ball now. Syracuse will apply pressure. Tom Nelson, Delira, Zulberti is on him. Harley with a big stick, sending it back to Delira. Whistle, he may have stepped out of bounds. He did. Maybe a little difficult for an opposing team to know exactly where the playing field ends.
Lots of lines down there.
Yeah, the back line is drawn right through the named Syracuse in the football end zone.
One of the things about Kavanaugh's injury, we talked to him, that kind of a sprain, Dave, is something that sometimes you can come back and it's still going to bother you. A sprained ankle, sometimes it's better to have a broken ankle, I think, than one of those sprains. But he's young and tough. I'm sure he'll be back in a couple of weeks if the doctor lets him.
Tom Nelson to Neil Ault. Zulberti. They work it to Brannigan. His shot is wide. Played nicely by Zulberti. Quickly, they go back into the offense. Here's Gordy Mapes. Clock smothered out there.
All the sticks up, and you can't shoot through all the sticks if you can't beat somebody one-on-one. That's exactly what's going to happen, and they're going to get a lot of help and double team and slide, keep those sticks up. And
there was Lloyd Newton sacrificing the body on that play. Lloyd Newton.
Shots on goal. Syracuse obviously out shooting Delaware, and Delaware obviously pretty accurate in their shooting and have cooled off a little bit, but Syracuse had to apply the pressure. There's the saves. Delaware 25, 11 for Syracuse.
Great feet, great legs under Sepulveda. Look at that move. Knocked away from him by Badwini. He takes a shot after making the play. Canizzo goes down. He was run over by two Syracuse men, O'Donnell and Nelson. They call the push, and Delaware gets it back. The Blue Hens, being coached by Bob Schillinglaw, now in his eighth year. Before his stint at Delaware, he coached Massachusetts Maritime Academy. Also played for the Bryan Lacrosse Club out of Boston.
Pass up over now. Clear the ball easily, does Delaware, and bring it down and put the pressure on Syracuse.
Sepulveda is going to get there. John Lux has it. Gets it now to Jeff Kirby, number 22. Spencer, back-to-back, two men standing right in the crease. Randy Powers behind the net.
Syracuse doing a nice job defensively, sticking pretty much with their man-to-man. Delaware, if they're going to make a run, they've got a lot of time to do it, and they got to be patient.
Lux having trouble getting pressure.
Sheehan all over him down there and really putting the pressure on Lux.
And finally, they take it away from him. Now Dan Pratt runs it down. He sends cross field to Chris Burt, up ahead for O'Donnell. Syracuse with the transition game now. Behind the cage, here's the man coming in. Jeske, they overthrow him. And a marker is down.
They're offside.
Right in front of the bench. Carbone was rushing on for Delaware. Tim Nelson, who began his career at North Carolina State, then came to Syracuse, led this Orange team to a national championship and two other appearances in the championship game against Hopkins.
Guyrie has been doing, I think, a better job that third quarter. Dave, a little more confident, I think, after he got a little shaky there in the second quarter. Syracuse working the ball around now with number five, Tom Nelson, up on top.
It is a 9-6 game, 11 minutes left. Zulberti, checked by Kemp. Alt to Brannigan. Now here's Corey. He faked the shot from the weak side. Alt lost the angle. Back out it goes to Brannigan. Syracuse has to set it up again.
See the body position they play. Keep the sticks up. And when they pass over that zone, they try to knock it down. And you've seen some of those basketball-type passes, Dave, that are very similar when they're up against a zone in basketball. And Syracuse had a little bit of trouble with it. And they've not been able, as we said, to what they did against Cortland is end up going one-on-one. And we're going to get a timeout now from the University of Delaware with 10:37 left to go in this quarter. And we'll be back shortly after this message with the score, Syracuse 9, Delaware 6.
Imagine living in a place surrounded by acres of natural beauty, where old world charm isn't a thing of the past, where children have room to grow, and where four superb seasons offer a variety of opportunities to be explored year round. Imagine living in a place like this. You do.
You gotta share in Syracuse. You gotta share Syracuse, New York.
As you watch it live from Rogers Cable Systems, Cable 13, at the Seneca Lane, the bid by Tony Giglio.
Oh, it's going to be close. He's there.
Force that short pass.
Here's Trina. Faking it, Todd Nelson, and the shot! He scores!
Now we gotta get it up.
Yes!
There's your score, Syracuse 9, Delaware 6. We have had only two goals in the first 17 minutes of the second half. I don't know if I can recall another game ever played here in the Dome in which there has been so few goals scored in such a long time period.
Tenacious defense, as we said, Delaware, once again, to stick up on the pass, and they have done that all game.
Nelson sending it out to Corey. He beats a man who goes down and is slow getting up, and there's the score. Joe Jr. went down, number 11, had a tough time getting up, and Corey, wearing the smile, gets the goal.
Well, they have done a superb job defending Syracuse, but with just a question of how long before Syracuse got a good shot off. And there's Corey Jr. down, and he gets beat out there. They try to slide to take up the slack, but they beat Delira on the offside.
Second goal of the game by Tom Corey, and Syracuse now with a little bit of breathing room at 10-6.
Face-offs pretty close, as we said. Syracuse got to be pleased. Andy Smith in there now. He got the last face-off, too.
Neil Alt seeing a lot of playing time.
Oh, off the stick of Delaware, I believe. We'll see what the call is. Yep.
We haven't seen Todd Curry really come back on. He took one more turn, but he's on the sideline with helmet off, and I believe he is through for the duration of this game.
You know those hamstring injuries, those are the ones that'll bother you through the whole season, so I think they're going to try to rest one of the thoroughbreds.
Syracuse is leading by four goals at 10-6. We have just under 10 minutes left. Gordy Mapes hardly played him. Corey looks for his shot. Back to Mapes. Mapes to the weak side. Jesse. And there's another goal as he beats Delira through the legs.
Poupard slid over to try to get him, but as they whip that ball around, they catch the defense sliding. They got Poupard out of position, and Jeske got a left-handed shot off at the last minute.
Syracuse
as they take the ball, there's Mapes behind. Jeske up on the wing, steps in, takes the left-handed shot.
Goal by 11, Jeske assists by...
Tom Corey made the first pass from way out, and even his passes are hard, and that might have frozen the defense as you look at Todd Curry through for this game.
See what the call is. They're going to call Smith on a hold, I think, number 12. He's taken two face-offs in a row. He's a freshman out of Phoenix, Maryland. And Andy Smith has been getting some time. We have not seen, although maybe one pass for Leland Rogers, number 10, one of the Syracuse specialists. But Smith had been pretty successful until that hold cost Syracuse possession.
Randy Powers to Butch Marino. Back it goes to Powers. Steve Shaw exchanging with Powers. They try to cheat in toward the goal. Burtz playing defense out against Powers. Metzbauer to Canizzo, to Shaw. To Lux, Marino. Here's Powers. Score! He started down low and he came up high in the upper left-handed corner. And Randy Powers has scored.
For a little guy, he gets a real hard shot. And Powers, part of the West Genesee Lacrosse factory, starts right and just keeps right on going with that crank. And Guyery, late reaction. Now that can be excused when you get kind of shot by Powers. But Delaware with 9:04 left, still right in this game. 11-7. And Smith comes up with it against a new faceoff man. That was wine fault for Delaware.
Powers with one goal and two assists in the game. Marino has a pair of goals. Powers is the all-time leading goal scorer at Delaware. Mapes now to Jeske. Neil All is heading off the field. John Zulberti comes on.
You know, it's funny, Kavanaugh said that he didn't think his teammates were really inspired, and I think maybe they're going to learn a lesson that you can't take anybody lightly. There's just an ISO. Oh,
and
over the head by Poupard.
They took it away from Zulberti. And on the ensuing action, an infraction committed by Syracuse, so Delaware gets it. 8:16 to go. Delaware's down by four. They need a goal soon.
Zulberti pushed Poupard, who did a nice job of going right over the head and taking the ball away from Zulberti. And with 8:16 left, you're right, Dave, it's time for Delaware to come up with a fast one and put some pressure on Syracuse. They're going to put a little pressure on this clear.
Yeah, the sign came from the bench.
Oh, nice job.
Had it stripped away. Here's a three-on-one break. Mapes? Yes.
Corey waited till the last second and just popped that assist off perfectly, and the crowd loved it. You know, lacrosse is a game where you can get as much of a kick out of an assist as a goal, and watch Corey. That ball was stripped from Delaware, and there it is, the last minute, the head down and then up, and he went up over the shoulder.
So Gordy Mapes gives Syracuse a five-goal advantage again at 12-7. Gordy seeing a lot more playing time this year, not a starter with Curry coming back, but based upon the re-injury that Curry has suffered, we may see Mapes back in the starter's role.
Shaw again and Smith again, and Shaw controls but just dumps the ball over his shoulder. Syracuse hustling on the ground ball, going to lose it, however.
Andy Smith and Mark Brannigan combining there to force the turnover by Delaware.
Delaware on the ground ball, however, and we'll have an opportunity now to get back within striking distance, down by five, 12-7 with 7:40 and counting in this last quarter.
They've really played all around an excellent game, Delaware has, and you hope for their sake this game does not become too one-sided because it would not be indicative of the way they played. And right here, they toss the ball away. Syracuse will get it.
Might mention number 28, Sheehan, the man who is going to bring the ball in for Syracuse, has played quietly but steadily today. He's taken the ball away a couple of times, but one of the, perhaps the premier defensemen in the East and around the country, actually.
Desco to Pratt. They faked it to Rossi. Pratt will wing it way across the field.
Sheehan on the recipient, and a real long pass.
Goalie comes out. Delira came about 40 yards out of the cage. And did a good job of breaking up that play. Quickly now, Delaware tries to get back into their offense. Powers comes on. So does Marino. Lux is heading toward the sideline. Shaw is on. So is Metzbauer. Randy Powers being dogged by Desco. Lux, who checked out, comes right back on, looking for the pass as he comes down the field. Nobody plays him. Now he gets it. Sends behind the net. Metzbauer with a spin move. Loose
ball
in
down
front.
The crease,
and
yeah.
Dan Pratt digs it out. Leaves it for Gary. Somebody yelled, Jimmy, Jimmy. Sheehan has it. Or maybe it's Donahue, 26,
yes.
Not Sheehan. Corey back to Donahue. He'll take it. Great save, Delira. He has played an outstanding game.
Boy, he has. Oh, now we're going to get another penalty here as that ball rocketed up to the midfield.
Gerard Delira, what a game he has played.
He's had 26 saves on 38 SU shots, and that's just a real super percentage. And this one is just a blistering shot. Watch him get in front of it. Saw the crease man there turn his head and say, ooh, I don't want to see if I don't want to have to take this one. And boy, Delira got a stick on it. That's what that big stick is for. He did a super job. The defense for Delaware, that shifting zone defense where they keep the sticks up and have knocked down a myriad of passes and have done an all-around good job. They had little problems clearing in the first quarter, but that problem seems to be solved.
They pass it across the zone. Now back out to Nelson. Corey lost the ball. Joe Jr., number 11, has it. Tried to get it back into the stick of Delira. Out front, Corey scores.
Great pass. Behind the back pass. And Delira is having some point blankers taken at him. A lot of action down in the crease. There's the ball down. They tried to scoop it up. Delaware did, lost it. Watch the pass. There's the pass. What a beauty.
Syracuse's 13th goal by number 42.
Corey.
Tom Corey.
You know, there's really no adjusting to Corey's shot. Either you have the stick in the right place or you're just not going to stop it. It's just coming too fast.
And when you can get that kind of a pass like Zulberti got off, you're all set.
Beautiful face off by Shaw. He took it all the way in and then was denied.
O'Donnell stripped him of the ball.
Randy Powers went for it. Sheehan has it. Now Guyry. Lux takes a run at him. Totally legal part of the game. Dan Pratt with it. Coming down toward 5 minutes to go. Syracuse in control. Brannigan with the ball. Alt and Jeschke both come on. Jeschke has it. Look how fast Syracuse moves that ball now. Neil Alt driven off the play by Shaw. And it'll be Delaware ball. Good defensive play by Shaw, who has hustled from start to finish.
Yes, he has, and has done an excellent job for Delaware. You know, it's a small part of the game, but an important one. There's Mrs. Simmons, the wife of the coach, with a lot of fans around her here, and she loves to watch lacrosse. Well, I was going to say, one of the things that Delaware has had a little problem doing is the fakes to the box, and then the Syracuse comes back out. And that's cost them a goal or two. And Syracuse hustling, getting the jump coming on and not being covered by Delaware. But Delaware has looked as well as I think they could look until this final quarter, actually the last part of this quarter, and they've had the problems. Getting a little tired, I think.
4.5 minutes to go. Delaware looking for some offense now. Randy Powers had the avenue, faked the shot, faked the pass, ducks under Desco. Still being played tight by Desco. Real cat and mouse game now. Hesitation moves.
Desco has been on him the whole game.
Can't find a cutter.
Desco trying to work over the head, lets him go.
Now he finds a man. Not a good opportunity. And the ball goes out of bounds, so Syracuse will get it. Randy Powers really worked hard to try to create something, but there just was nothing there.
He does a nice job, you're absolutely right, of trying to create something. And they're going to try to get at least one or two people on the ball, see if they can't force a quick turnover. Syracuse will redirect, take it back, and set up the clear. And they forced a long pass over to Pratt. Oh, bad pass.
Way up and over everybody. Off the stick of Rossi, Chris Rossi.
Syracuse has had an opportunity to play a lot of people. Delaware has used a good number of people. You can see conditioning has not really been a factor. Both teams in good shape, but lacrosse is a game where you've got to really work at it.
This is going to be a tough loss for Delaware because they lost two earlier games to New Hampshire and Navy, but played very well here.
Well, Navy's always a tough lacrosse team, and New Hampshire has their ups and downs, and they apparently caught this Delaware team because I am impressed with them, Dave.
The kind of team that could surprise some people later in the year. Lux with a return to Sepulveda, and Delaware gets on the scoreboard for the eighth time. 13-8 now, Syracuse.
They certainly have given Syracuse just about all they wanted with 3:22 left. And there's the pass across. Guyry back in position, but not able to get a stick on it. He has not been consistent today, Jimmy Guyry. He has, I'll tell you one thing, he consistently is able to get the ball out and start the transition game, but he has not been consistent in his saves. And, you know, this is only his first really full year of competition. Redshirted last year. I think he's going to really help him out. Just going to take him a little while, and this has not been one of his best games, but he has been spectacular at times and let some go by.
Not a bad performance by any stretch of the imagination. 3 minutes to go now. Syracuse leads 13-8. One-on-one time. Jeschke missing. Syracuse keeps. Carbone. Poupard. Come on. So does Gallagher.
Jeschke, one of the co-captains, kind of a story in himself, been injured, was in his freshman year in an automobile accident, hurt his knee, had an operation, and in an off-season accident, he lost problems with his toes, so he's had a tough life, but right there you see...